Now to the ongoing turmoil in Cuba and Haiti. President Biden is contemplating his next move and considering how to back up his words of support with action. Among the questions, what role the U.S. should play in assisting them. Christina Ruffini has the latest from the White House. Christina, good morning.
Good morning, Dana. Well, while his predecessor drew criticism for allegedly calling Haiti an expletive, President Biden raised eyebrows this week, referring to Cuba as a failed state. But both countries are causing problems for the administration, which wanted to focus its foreign policy on countering Russia and China, not dealing with crises 90 miles off the Florida coast.
Days of anti-government protests, followed by government crackdowns and arrests across Cuba, have led to the inevitable question. What, if anything, is the U.S. going to do about it?
At this point, it's basic human rights.
Quarantine lockdowns, food and medical shortages, and a spike in COVID cases have prompted widespread outcry. Cuban Americans are urging the White House to take action.
I have a lot of family still left in Cuba, and a lot of family that still haven't heard from.
There are a number of things that we would consider doing to help the people of Cuba.
The administration has not signaled it's ready to relax the trade embargo, which the Cuban government blames for the country's economic hardship. And even allowing Americans to wire money back to their families in Cuba, known as remittances, comes with complications.
I would not do that now because the fact is, it's highly likely that the regime would confiscate those remittances or big chunks of it.
Meanwhile, in Haiti, an estimated quarter of the nation's economy comes from those remittances. The government's request for American troops to help stabilize the country after the assassination of President Jovenel Moise has been denied. It's still not clear who ordered the attack or why, nor is it clear exactly who is supposed to be running the country. On Friday, hundreds of supporters gathered to greet former Haitian President Jean-Bertrand Aristide as he returned from seeking medical treatment in Cuba. Ousted in a coup in 2004, Aristide is a popular but polarizing figure and a potentially volatile addition to the political powder keg in Port-au-Prince.
Now, the White House has sent a team of State Department advisors as well as federal agents to aid Haiti in that investigation. And we asked the White House if, in addition to Cuba, it considers Haiti or any other country's failed states. We did not hear back.
How about that, Christina? Thank you.